Hey guys, welcome to Time Trail, and today's video is going to be on whether or not every collection needs a Rolex. And the short answer is absolutely fucking not. Not every collection needs a Rolex, but let's go through some of the points of why you would want a Rolex. If you want a one watch collection, I would get a Rolex because they're so versatile. This Yachtmaster 1 or a Datejust or even a GMT or a Sub, it can be used as a dress watch. It's not truly a dress watch, but it can be used as a dress watch and it can be used in a casual setting. And you don't have to worry about breaking these watches for the most part. They're very hardy. They're very durable. Stainless steel, obviously. They use, good quality materials to be able to manufacture these watches the way that they do. So very durable. The value retention is great on these watches. So again, if you want to, maybe in a few years move away from this watch or sell it or whatever you want to do, you'll be better off. There'll be less hassle with this watch than with other watches that you may have to sell on your own to get the amount of money that you want to get out of it. So those are a few reasons to get a Rolex. You also get the recognition of the brand, right? So you can sit there at a meeting or on a plane or whatever, at a dinner, and people will recognize you have a Rolex on your wrist. And in a way, whether or not people want to accept it, in certain situations, there will be a certain level of respect or a certain level of recognition, even if somebody doesn't say that they see that watch. They said, hey, I see you wearing a Rolex. They wouldn't say it, but they recognize it. So that's one of the reasons. Some people don't give a fuck. It is what it is. Most of the time, it doesn't matter. But something to keep in mind if you want to, if that's one of the things that you want. So the other watch that I have here is my Chopard. This is a watch you can probably get for $4,500, $5,000. And, it's not going to give you the same brand recognition, but it's going to give you the same durability and it's going to give you a little bit more of a different look. It's going to be a more kind of decorated dial. It's going to be higher water resistance. It's got the sapphire bezel, which not a lot of watches have. They're getting into ceramic instead of sapphire. It's a unique watch. It's got a micro rotor movement in it, so you move away from the norm. But you're giving up the value retention and you're giving up the brand recognition. This watch, they'll probably give me half of what I bought it for in trade-in if I just were to trade it in. Of course, you can haggle a little bit and whatever else. I would be better off probably selling this watch on eBay if I ever want to get rid of it. I don't want to get rid of it. But it's something that you have to keep in mind. I also have a watch like this, which is a little cheap, a little LeCoultre that was $1,300, $1,400. That I got on eBay, and I thoroughly enjoy this watch, and it could be a daily watch, and I was wearing it for the past 3-4 days. However, it's not waterproof, and when you go vintage and not waterproof, you have to be very careful as to what situations. I live in Florida, so the humidity gets really, it's really high, and it's really hot and humid and whatever else, and it can fuck up some of these watches, so you have to be careful. And if it's on a leather strap, of course, you're gonna ruin that strap, sweating, humidity, all that stuff, the sun. So you have to be mindful of that when buying these vintage pieces. But you could easily have a triple watch, a vintage piece collection, $1,500 a piece or something like that. And you could have just as much fun as having, a watch like this or having the, Rolex, Yachtmaster, GMT, Sub, or whatever. Which I actually think that this is the least boring out of the three, but the other two, they're good, great watches, but they're just boring. I don't think that this is a boring watch because at least it provokes a reaction in somebody. They'll say, oh, wow, that looks fucking weird, or that's ugly, or whatever. Or they'll say, wow, it looks great. It's crazy. I love the color of the dial. I love whatever the look. I love whatever, So it creates a discussion. And this watch is a little bit better. The show part is a little bit better of that, but still a regular kind of piece. It's not as crazy. That's why, you don't really need a Rolex in your collection to have a well-rounded collection, or to make or break your collection. You can have a lot of fun. And the point is having fun, guys. And also, with it, keeping the fun in mind, don't buy junk. Don't go buy a Gucci watch. Don't go buy whatever, like that type of bullshit. Keep in mind what you're buying. Always try and get the best example that you can afford. Whether it's, a little LeCoultre like this, go and search and don't be impatient. Wait for the right watch. And you amass a nice little collection of, very well, minty pieces. And you might never need a Rolex. Especially if your lifestyle doesn't, if you're in an office all day, and you can have a lot of fun with these kind of watches, you don't need a Rolex, It's not for everybody. However, you know, if you want the recognition, like I said, and if you want something that's just a one watch deal, then go ahead, go get a Rolex, and you're gonna be better off in the long run than somebody that you know, does a bunch of other dumb shit with buying other watches. I mean, they may like, but they'll lose money. But that's how it goes, you know. Most stuff, you know, you lose money. You know, let's say you like to party or you like to take trips. You can't cash in your memories, guys. So you pissed away. You go on a trip, you spend $5,000, $3,000, whatever it is, it's gone. At least this, if you wear for a year, you can get some equity out of it. Even if you lose an extra $800, $1,000, or whatever it is, you still can cash in that. You know, that you can't cash in experience. Now it's give or take, of course. You know, you spend the way you want to spend. Same thing with the watches. Some people prefer to go on a trip and buy something. Some people will rather buy, you know, off-brand like a Chopard or a LeCoultre or something like that, then go buy a Rolex. It's all about personal opinion, of course. But with all that in mind, guys, tell me what you guys are wearing on the daily, and tell me what, you know, your thoughts are on whether a Rolex is a necessary part of every collection. Or if, you know, you can go out through your whole collecting life without having to ever purchase a Rolex. Thank you, guys. Let me know what you guys think of the video in the comment section below. Like, dislike, whatever the fuck you want. And subscribe, though, whether it's hate or love. Thank you.